you just two problems that you're going to do completely on your own. And from there, we're going to do a little bit of, you're going to be moving a bit, depending on what I observe when you do those two problems. And then from there, we'll get to our quizzes last. So by the time you leave today, you should feel way more confident in factoring, really, any problem that's in standard form, whether the first coefficient is 1 or not. Okay? So, that being said, you and your partner need one whiteboard and a marker to share. If you are a triad, that is fine. Let's recap Sage Scribe. Somebody tell me how Sage Scribe works. Tell me one thing. Monica, what's one thing we know about Sage Scribe? Okay, one person's doing the problem or doing the thinking, right? Who is that person? Okay, we'll start, pause. The person who is going to be, the person who's going to be solving the problem will be the person who's most confident to start, okay? That person has the marker and whiteboard or no? No. So remember, writers, you're just writing whatever the sage is telling you. Okay? So whoever is more confident, whoever is more confident, you do not have the marker and the whiteboard to start. Okay? We ready? Here's your first one. We'll ease into it today. It's Monday. I get it. We'll ease into it. Okay? Copy the problem and then sages. Take it away. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You shouldn't need to hold them up for me because you should have checked, right? Your two factors should be x plus 4 and x plus 5, yes? Okay. Erase. Switch roles. Here's your next one. If the sage, is struggling, you can coach them a bit. Remember, don't just give them the answer. You should be coaching them if they need a little help.
We're distributing this, right? So that would be the 3x, but if I multiply this 3x times the 5, -15, that's huge.
Do your best to finish in the next 2 minutes. If you don't, not the end of the world, but do your best to finish in the next 2 minutes. Raise your hand if I did not put a number on your paper yet. Everybody has a number? Yep. Okay. Listen carefully, please. If you have number 1 written on your paper, you are going to, if you're already at this table, that's fine, but I want my 1s at tables 7, which is there, 8, and 9. So if you have a 1 on your paper, pause, don't move yet. Hang on, I'm going to tell everybody where they're going. If you have a 1 on your paper, you're moving to tables 7, 8, 9. Okay? If you have a 2 on your paper, you are moving, don't move yet. You are moving to, this is table 1, right? 1, 2, or 4. Don't move yet. If you have a 2 on your paper, you're moving to 1, 2, or 4. And if you have a 3 on your paper, you're in tables 3, is this 5, 5, and 6. Questions about where I want you? Yeah? Where's 1? 7, 8, 9. directions, and then get started. Check it real quick by redistributing back up.